All right, hello, this is John Barton from JB Cases. I'm here with Bill Feeney, and Bill and I are going to talk real quick about a case that he special ordered. You guys know that custom is our big deal, and if you can tell us what you want, we'll try our best to build it. We may not always get it right the first time, but we'll keep trying until we get it right, unless it's just cost us too much and you don't want to pay for it. But I think that in Bill's case, you know, we did a decent job and we got it. So, Bill, what are the things on here that you wanted specifically custom?
Well, a number of things, John. My old case, I have a lot of things I use when I shoot.
Right.
So, I needed to have one compartment that could hold everything that I had in my old case, hanging on outside backs that I wanted to carry around.
Right.
Also, I need to have shooting glasses.
Right. So he's got shooting glasses, right?
I have shooting glasses. I wanted them protected. John, if that's already customized.
So he wanted a solid way to protect the shooting glasses that was different than just like a glasses case.
So what we did, John came up with this, which totally protects it as a mark.
So let's see how that works here. So this just Velcros in and out.
So then we had to actually go and get these.
So it's a hard plastic piece, as you can see, and it's basically our tube. It comes from one of our tubes. We just cut a section out, covered it all with fabric, and put some Velcro on there so it can go in. And part of the reason Bill's here today, he ordered this case, was last year, right?
Yeah, last year.
So he ordered the case last year, but he came in today because he had a little problem where the zipper was catching on the corner, so it was tearing the fabric off. And so we determined a couple things. One is we could have made this a little bit shorter to make the clear the corner. But the other thing is because it had Velcro on the top and bottom, it made it harder to get it to seat all the way. So if we close it all the way to the bottom here, right here. So with a little bit of thinking about how to put it in, we've solved that problem. So now it can be put in and sit all the way to the bottom, and then we've solved the clearance problem. So I think you won't have that issue anymore where the zipper's tearing up the fabric.
Yeah, perfect.
And what else did we do for you there?
On the inside.
Oh, yeah, yeah. He only knows
this is how, when you get the case, John also ships you a lot of flexible, bendable dividers that you can put in here however you want to configure it. So I have my chalk in here. I have my bridge head. I have two holders.
Everything in its place.
Everything. And then I got some Velcro straps and put for my
glove. Now check this out. So this is what I tell you guys all the time. Velcro, any Velcro works on our fabric. So what Bill did is he went out and made himself a little strap, or got a strap, just a piece of elastic with two pieces of Velcro, and it works perfectly to hold his glove in place. So you're not limited to only the things that we provide you. You know, you can DIY this any which way you want with just simply easily available materials and just a little bit of thought.
Now, another feature, I wanted to have an easy way to carry my extensions. So I had John take a 4x8 case and modify it.
So this is a larger diameter extension. So what we did is we took a 4x8 tube, and by the way, our 4x8s are about the same size as other people's 3/6s, so he didn't really get a much bigger footprint here. And we turned it into, what is it, a 3x4? So we turned it into a 3x4, so he's got plenty of room for his cues and a perfect spot for his extension. We modified that interior and made it a little wider, and it also stops at the perfect height right there, so he doesn't have to worry about it. Well, again,
I put a dowel in there to make it stop.
See, DIY.
Because the perfect thing is, if I switch to using the hollow tube.
Right.
I just take the stop out and put the tube in.
See, there you go. You got a dowel in there. Now, is your interior removable? Did we do it, or have we?
I would not try to remove it. I don't know.
I'm not sure if his is removable or not, but all of our. All of our interiors now are removable, which means that if you want to put stuff in there like dowels and things like that, and you don't have to take the case and turn it over and beat on it or whatever to get those things out, you can just take the interior out and fish it out that way. Just kind of squeeze it up until it gets out, and there you go. So previously, you know, when people wanted to space their case, and they would have to stuff things in there, and then those things would be harder to get out. So we do provide some spacers for that purpose, but if you don't have them, a little bit of thought, do it yourself, and there you go.
Just got a little dowel down there, and you're good to go. So another thing was kind of cool. I wanted, in case there's an honest person out there that I forget my case, I had John put in there, custom-made, and my name and phone number.
There you go. So if he happens to forget his case there after a hard night of drinking, you know, he looks like a party guy, don't he?
Yeah, right. Maybe 30 years ago.
He would, you know, someone would be able to easily contact him real quick and say, hey, you forgot your case. So there you go.
One last thing. Backpack straps. So comfortable. It's unbelievable.
There you go, guys.
If you need a case, I can't speak highly enough of it.
Backpack straps. Save your back. Save your stroking arm. Be comfortable. Be hands-free. And thank you, Bill. Appreciate it.
John, I appreciate the case.
Thank you.
Best one I've ever had.
So there you go, folks. Custom means custom. Custom means customer. Trademark. Don't use that.
It's got the backpack straps.
Bye.